Hi, hello and welcome to the video presentation. This presentation is intended for the subject Analog Electronics BKE2333. We are Group 3 members from 2BEKG Section 4. This presentation consists of 5 major parts. The first part will be the project background. Second is methodology. Third is simulation and graph. Fourth is calculation. Fifth is conclusion and recommendation.
Hello, I'm Sudhakar Elangu. I'm going to present project background. This is the question. So basically, we have to design a class AB power amplifier for a CD player system which has 6 ohm speaker. The condition is that we have to make sure the output power of the power amplifier is somewhere around 4 watt, approximately 4 watt. And then we are also required to perform certain procedures. For example, like we have to design the solution based on Villars table, and then we have to design the power amplifier circuit by using BJT as the active device, and then we have to simulate the circuit and analyze the result. And furthermore, we have to determine few important parameters by using formulas.
So the objective of the project is to design class AB amplifier circuit in producing desired output as load. Secondly, to apply the theoretical learning and concept through practical circuit simulation. Last but not the least, to perform simulation analysis using simulation software PSPICE.
Hi, my name is Tan Hong Lee and I will continue with problem statement. A CD player is invented to produce sound from the CD drive. So, without the CD player, it is hard to play music from the CD drive. So, a simple CD player is very economical and affordable by everyone. A CD player design need to be simpler circuit and cheap in the manufacturing price. Thus, class AB power amplifier is used in this CD player. Is the background of class AB amplifier. Class AB amplifier used in between conduction angle of both class A and B. The output collector current flow of varies for more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree of input AC signal cycle. The Q point is located on load line just above the cutoff region. Output current flow for more than half cycle but less than full cycle of input AC signal. The conduction angle is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. So to get output for full cycle of input and increase efficiency, it is connected in push-pull arrangement. Thus the power dissipation is less, so efficiency is high. Next, methodology. The circuit and parameters. So for parameters, design is set to 7.6 volt and frequency 500 Hz. For R1 and R2, it's set to 200 ohms. D1 and D2 is biasing diode, while Q1 is NPN BJT and Q2 is PNP BJT. VCC is set to 20 volt. And VEE is set to 5 volt negative DC voltage. And RL is set to 6 ohm as given in the question. Simulation and graph. So this is the circuit for class AB power amplifier. So there are several types of amplifier, which are resistor biasing and diode biasing. So in this project, we are using diode biasing power amplifier circuit. So the circuit consists of electric component, for example, diode, resistor, BJT, and voltage input. First, we have to construct the circuit as this. For V sine, the value is set to 7.6 volt and 5 kHz frequency. R1 and R2 are 200 ohms. VCC 20 volts and VEE 5 volt. So Q1 is NPN BJT while Q2 is PNP BJT. So the load resistor is set to 6 ohm and the desired output power is 4 watt. After setting all the values for each parameters, we have to put the probe at which we want to find the graph, which is at input, supply and output side. So next we will need to set the value for transient analysis, which is from 0 to 2 milliseconds. After that, you can simulate the circuit. After simulate, we will get the graph for input, output, and supply. So this is VCC, which is 20 volts. So this will be the voltage and current at input. So this V sign, we will set the value to 7.6 volt, and here we are getting the maximum voltage as 7.6 volt. And the current, we are getting 132 milliampere. Next, this is the voltage and current waveform at output side. So for voltage, we are getting 6.9 volt as maximum value, and current we are getting 1.136 as the maximum value. As you all see in this graph, it is not fully sinusoidal graph. This is because the VEE is set to 5 volt. Thus, the value for negative part is can only reach to 5 volt. So the value of voltage and current will be clipped. So if we want to find the fully sinusoidal graph, so we set the value of VEE to 20 volt, which is same as VCC.
Good morning, my name is Wong Kolong, and I will present about the calculation part. Firstly, I will explain about the theoretical calculation. Since the question requires the output power must be approximate to 4 volt, the load resistor is 6 ohm, and what is the output load voltage? So we have the output power equation here, and then we just substitute the parameter here inside the equation, and we will find the output load voltage is equal to 6.928 volt. Then next we find the peak load current, and then we have the equation of peak load current here, and then we just substitute the output load voltage and resistor load, and we will get the peak load current is equal to 1.1678. Then next we find the DC current from the supply, and then the DC current, we have the equation here, and then we just substitute the peak load current inside the equation, and we will find the DC current from the supply is equal to 0.743 ampere. Next, we find the power supply to the circuit. Power supply to the circuit is the power input. Then we just substitute the VCC and IDC inside the equation, and we will find the input power equal to 14.686 volt. Next, we already know the output power is equal to 4 watt. Then next, we find the power dissipated by each BJT transistor, and then we have the formula of power dissipated. Then we just substitute the input power and output power inside here, and we will find the power dissipated is equal to 5.43 watt. Lastly, we find the efficiency equal to output power divided by input power multiplied 100, and then lastly we will find the efficiency equal to 26.92%. Next, I will explain about the calculation from the simulation result. From the simulation result, we know the output load voltage is equal to 6.8776 watt, and then the resistor load is equal to 6 ohm, and we just substitute the parameter inside the output power, and then we will get the simulated output power is equal to 3.9418 watt. Next, we find the peak load current. Then we have the equation of peak load current, and we just substitute the output load voltage and the resistor load inside, and we find the peak load current is equal to 1.1463 ampere. Next, we find the DC current from the supply. So we have the formula equation here, and then we just substitute the peak load current to the formula, and we will find the DC current from the supply is equal to 0.7298 ampere. Next, we find the input power by substitute the VCC and IDC inside, and we will find the input power equal to 14.596 watt. Next, we find the power dissipate, and then we have the formula of
power disappear, and we just substitute the input power and output power inside the equation, and we will find the power disappeared is equal to 5.3271 watt. Lastly, we find the efficiency is equal to output power divided by input power multiplied 100, and we will find the efficiency equal to 27%. Next, I will explain about the load line. From the theoretical calculation, we first find the ICQ equal to VCC minus 0.7 divided by R1. So we substitute the parameter of VCC and R1 inside the equation, and we will find the ICQ equal to 0.0965 ampere. Next, we find the ICZ equal to VCC divided by R root. So we substitute the parameter inside, and we will find the ICZ equal to 3.33 ampere. Next, we find the VCEQ equal to VCC equal to 20 watt. Next, we find the Q point is equal to VCEQ and ICQ, and just substitute the VCEQ and ICQ inside, and we get the Q point is equal to 20 watt and 0.0965 ampere. Next, from the simulation result, we can also find the Q point. So IC from the simulation result is equal to 0.0965 ampere, and VCE from the simulation result is equal to 19.4 watt. So lastly, after we find the IC step value, VCC value, and Q point, we can draw the LC load line graph like that. And that's all for the LC load line.
My name is Tan Yihong Rachel, and now I will continue the part for conclusion and recommendation. For conclusion, the main objective of the project that was successfully achieved is design a Class AB power amplifier, apply the theoretical learning and concept through practical circuit simulation, and perform simulation analysis using simulation software. This project allows students to work as a team and allows students to learn analyze questions. It is very important when we work outside. The most important element to complete a project is teamwork. Students will find that the project is easier to handle when work as a team, and every team members handle their job perfectly. For recommendations, the project can be improved and upgraded by increasing the efficiency by changing its VCC or resistor value. Efficiency is very important when designing a project or circuit so that we can produce a better output power and save more costs. It can be applied to normal use if the efficiency is high enough. The circuit can be better if the usage of element reduced, and it will save costs of producing the object. That's all from me. Thank you.